we are back to Bragg Stadium as we get set to get started here in Bragg Stadium, as the Aggies will be kicking off, and doing the honors will be Cody Jones, the place kicker. The Rattlers are going to send.
Rattler fans, welcome back to
James
Bragg
Owens, deep to receive for the Rattlers. It's opening kickoff. Again, the Rattlers decked out in black today, and the Aggies and Rattlers are just about underway. Mike, we've got a good one and a beautiful afternoon for college football.
We could use a good return right here to set us up in some good field position. So here we go.
All right, Cody Jones approaches. He gets off a high end-over-end kick, and James Owens is going to field this at the 13, 20, 25, 30, still on his feet, 40, 45 midfield. James Owens going to run out of bounds at the 47, 46 to 45-yard line of the Aggies of North Carolina A&T, and the Rattlers will open up with outstanding
field
position.
James Owens with the return.
Went with a little pooch kick, Keith, and it sort of backfired
on a first and 10.
All right, here we go. The Rattlers will start at Mason Felix at the wide receiver, Zary Patterson, the left tackle. Keontae Cash goes at the left guard. It's Kevin House, the center. Reginald Turner is the right guard. Doug Almendares is the right tackle. Michael Etheridge at tight end. James Owens will get the start at tailback. Damian Fleming, the Rattler quarterback, 6'3", 210, a junior out of Jacksonville, Rebalt. Lonnie Lockett gets the start at fullback. And Dennis Hall, the youngster, Mike, stepping up, gets the start today at wide receiver. And the Rattlers go twins to the far boundary, isolate near side. They give it to Owens, and he's going to be trapped behind the line of scrimmage and drop for a loss on the tackle by Devontae Grant, the senior out of Charlotte, North Carolina. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Rattlers Sports Network.
Rattlers lose 4 yards on the play, brings up a second down and 14 to go.
Loss of 4 on the play for FAMU. Second down and 14 now for the Rattlers. Ball's resting at the Aggie 49-yard line. The Rattlers moving left to right or heading toward the south end zone. And here we go. Damian Fleming sets the same formation. Twins to the far boundary. Isolation near side. And Fleming's going to be hit and trapped and sacked way back at about the 37-yard line. And on the stop for the Aggies of A&T is big number 93, Daniel Penix, 6'1", 240, the sophomore out of High Point, North Carolina. And so we're going to bring up third down now and about 25 yards to go for Rattler first down.
Yeah, the Aggies came with an all-out blitz that time, locked up man-to-man in the secondary, and Damian Fleming did not have a chance as the Rattler offensive line couldn't pick it up.
All right, here we go. The Rattlers send twins to either side this time, a spread formation, as Fleming has James Owens in the backfield. And Fleming takes the snap, hands off the draw play. It's James Owens, and Owens breaking tackles, gets back near the original line of scrimmage, goes down about a yard short of the original line of scrimmage, but it's going to bring up fourth down and about 11 to go for the Rattlers, and it'll send on Colby Blanton to punt. The Aggies are going to send Devontae Graham, the dangerous return man out of Tallahassee, to receive this kick.
And look for A&T to try to put pressure on the Rattler punter, who has been up and down this year.
Colby Blanton gets off a beautiful tight spiral, and this was
boy, that's a great punt.
Yep, it's going to hit and go out of bounds.
Boy.
At about the 6-yard line. And so the Aggies of North Carolina A&T will have their first possession of the afternoon from their own 6. And they'll start Desmond Lawrence at wide receiver. William Robinson, the left tackle. Donye Gorrell is the left guard. Ronald Canty is the center. Timothy Sunkins is the right guard. Nathan Isles is the right tackle. Devin Moore is the tight end. At running back, it'll be Tariq Cohen. Lewis Kendall starts at quarterback, 6'1", 205-pound senior out of Atlanta, Georgia. Anthony McMinn, the second, is the fullback, and Darren Bullock, the other wide receiver. And here we go. The Aggies send receivers to either side, and it is Kendall. Who sets his offense now, and we're ready to go. Kendall on first down gives to Tariq Cohen, the running back, and Cohen picks up a couple of yards. Drives it to about the 10-yard line. Picks up, say, three and or maybe four. Second down and six to go for A&T.
A&T going up tempo, back at the line of scrimmage ready.
Ball's resting at the Aggie 10-yard line. This time, Lewis Kendall shouts instructions, twin receivers to the near boundary, and Cohen in the backfield, and there's movement across the line of scrimmages. Big number, 71, William Robinson comes out of his stance.
Offense, number 71, 5-yard penalty, second down.
And that penalty is going to drive them back to their own 5-yard line now and make it second down and 11 to go for the Aggies from their own five.
Yeah, the Rattles start James Brodus at left end from Choctaw, Florida. Francis May, 6'10", 295, starts on the nose. Sean Ward is the right end from Fort Lauderdale.
Second down and 11. They give it to Cohen again. He's hit at the point of attack behind the line of scrimmage, but moves forward, shakes off that tackle, and fights his way back to the 10-yard line, actually maybe the 11, and it'll make it now third down and five for A&T.
On the outside, the Rattlers will have Michael Ducree and Akil Blunt. The inside linebackers are William Smalls and Bobby Jackson. The cornerbacks, Patrick Aikens and Terry Johnson. The safeties, Devin Roberts and John Ojo.
All right, Aggies with receivers to either side. This time, Kendall on a quarterback option turns upfield and goes down at about the 17-yard line, and that'll be enough to move the chains and keep this drive alive.
Yep, a little bit of an option look that time from
Lewis Kendall
as he came down. Faked it to his pitch man and turned upfield. He's going to have the first down out at the 22-yard line.
All right, Aggies send JoJo Span wide to the far boundary, a receiver near side, and go I formation this time. They give it to Cohen, and Cohen is hit and driven back by a host of black jerseys led by Big Frank Mays from the nose tackle position.
Make sure you're looking good in your orange and green this season for the
Looks like the inside linebacker, William Smalls, Keith, who had an outstanding game last week, also was in on that play. Going to bring up about a second down and eight as we get underway. Slight wind blowing from the north as a little coolness of the fall has come down to Florida.
Yeah, 10-28 to play, no score in Tallahassee. Aggies with a second down and eight to go, with ball resting at their own 19-yard line. Kendall back to pass, sets up, fires this pass out here, is tipped in the air and nearly picked off, but it's going to fall incomplete. Good defensive play over there.
Yeah, Terry Johnson on that play. He tipped the ball the first time and came back, actually tipped it again to make sure the receiver didn't get a little deflection. And the Rattlers now have that third and eight, Keith, and this has been the key down. The Rattlers have not been able to get off the field on these third downs. Penalties many times being the problem. Let's see if we can get off right now.
All right, Kendall from the gun, and he has a spread formation this time. Twin receivers to either side, and Tariq Cohen in the backfield. All right, Cohen takes the snap. They run the draw. They give it to Cohen. Actually, Kendall gave it to Cohen, and Cohen fights his way to about the 24-yard line, but that's going to bring up fourth down for North Carolina A&T, and a good positive sign, Mike, for the Rattler defense.
Big Frank Mays, Keith, made that play as he has moved to the nose guard when they go to the dime package. They bring in some faster guys. Number 54, Curtis Alexander, was on one end, along with number 17, Sean Ward.
All right, Terry Johnson, deep to receive the punt from Dominic Frescura, and Frescura gets off a beautiful kick, high kick, and Johnson feels it. He called for the fair catch and makes it at the Rattler 42-yard line. Still excellent field position for the Rattlers on our second offensive possession of the afternoon.
And actually, Keith, I think that was number 87, Trayvon Holmes.
Okay. 41-yard line.
Good field position again for the Rattlers, and we need to take advantage of it while we have it.
All right, let's see if our Elton Gumbel is standing by with some sideline updates for us. Elton, jump on in.
Yeah, I'm actually excited about how the defense responded to A&T. One of the things I was looking forward to is seeing how the defense would hold back this A&T offense. Of the 131 points A&T has scored this season, 83 of them have been in the first half. So that was a good sign that FAMU was able to stop them on their first possession.
All right, here we go. Rattlers send a man in motion. Caleb Brown in at fullback now for Damian Fleming. And we run the counter. And, boy, the Rattler running back was trapped behind the line of scrimmage, and he's going to be dropped back there. Devontae Grant led the Aggie attack to make the tackle. And we're going to lose about 3 yards on the play and make it second down and about 13 to go for a Rattler first down.
Yeah, the Aggies are using their quickness. They're getting a lot of penetration on each one of these running plays. And I'm pretty sure right now the Rattler offense has negative yards.
All right, second down and 13 for FAMU. 8:59 to play in the first quarter. No score, FAMU nothing, North Carolina A&T nothing. And this time, Damian Fleming with a wing left, sends a man in motion, fakes. Oh, we run the jet sweep. And
I think that was at Mason Felix.
And he's going to be trapped behind the line. We're actually going to get some positive yards on that one. They're going to mark his forward progress at our 40-yard line and make it third down and 11 now for Rattler first down.
.821 to go now in the first quarter. No score, as most of the game has been played right around the middle of the field where we are right now. Rattlers with another third and long.
All right, here we go. Rattlers are going to send triplets to the near boundary, isolated receiver to the far side, one setback. And Damian Fleming sets up, pulls it down, trapped behind the line of scrimmage, and another tackle for loss. Big number 97, Jamie Morris, 6'2", 275-pound, redshirt sophomore out of Raleigh, North Carolina, makes the stop for the Aggies, and it makes it fourth down and long for the Rattlers. It'll send on Colby Blanton to punt, and deep to receive will be Devontae Graham. All right, here we go. Blanton gets off an end-over-end kick. Graham lets it hit. It takes an Aggie roll, and the Rattlers stop it at the 31-yard line of A&T, where the Aggies will begin their third possession now of the first half.
And so far, so good for the Rattler defense. They have stepped up, and actually we've got a penalty marker, Keith, on the field.
Holding on the receiving team, number 29, 10 yards from the end of the run, first down.
All right, so that's going to back the Aggies up to their own 20-yard line. The Aggies moving right to left or heading toward the north end zone.
First and 10.
And coming up this week on Halftime at FAMU, our Glendale Presley talks with Dr. Victor Ebenusi, Dean of FAMU School of the Environment, about its commitment to producing graduates prepared to serve globally environment-related careers. That's coming up on Halftime at FAMU. All right, here we go. Lewis Kendall goes in an offset eye, twins to the far boundary, isolates number 84 over here to the near side. That's DeMonta Brown. And first and 10 for the Aggies from their own 20. And Kendall decides to, boy, a fumble on the play in the exchange between Kendall and Tariq Cohen. But Kendall alertly falls on the football, and it's going to make it second down and 15 now for the Aggies of North Carolina A&T.
Yeah, it looked as though they want to run the read option, but the quarterback pulled it out late and laid that football on the ground. Luckily for the Aggies, the quarterback was there to pick it up, but it is a long yardage situation now on second down.
All right, here we go. Kendall, two-back set, wants to pass. Boy, he wants to run. And actually, the Rattlers had a spy, and Kendall's going to be forced out of bounds at about the 14-yard line. So they're going to lose a couple of more yards, Mike, on this play.
Jonathan Pillow, Keith, in that safety, comes up and finally makes that tackle. Darren Parker, the youngster from out of Miami, Booker T. Washington, getting a start on the right corner today also.
So it's going to bring up third down now and about 16 yards to go for the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. 6:42 to play in the first quarter. There's no score in Tallahassee. FAMU and North Carolina A&T. Lewis Kendall is trapped. And, boy, he's going to be sacked way back at about the 3-yard line. That's an outstanding defensive play by Big Frank Mays. Mike, we talked to Frank at the press conference on Tuesday, and we asked him about his switch from playing on the outside to playing nose tackle. And he said, well, I had to make an adjustment, but my tackles are going up, so I'm okay with it.
And the first thing he said, there's a lot less running.
Big play by Frank Mays, and the Aggies are going to be forced to punt the punter for A&T Frescura near the back of the end zone. The Rattlers should get excellent field position out of this exchange. Terry Graham.
Trayvon Holmes going to let that
one Trayvon,
roll.
Okay. Trayvon lets it roll, but the Rattlers will have it first and 10 from our own 48-yard line. Excellent field position as we get set to start this possession. 5:42 to play in the first quarter.
The content of this Florida A&M University football broadcast on the Rattler Sports Network is the explicit copyrighted property of Florida A&M University. It is a direct support organization of Florida A&M University. This broadcast is a production of Vantage Media Partners of Florida, Incorporated.
All right, Damian Fleming set to go. Swings the pass out here. And the Rattler receiver, that's Al-Tariq McBurst, going to get maybe, actually going to lose 2 yards on the play and make it second down and 12 to go. So the offense, Mike, sputtering while the defense continues to play well.
Yeah, and right now we've got great field position that we're not taking advantage of, starting right around midfield all three of these first possessions.
All right, here we go. Fleming sets, Casey Glines, isolated receiver over here to the near boundary, and sends twins to the far side with Al-Tariq McBurst in the backfield. Fires this pass across the middle, and that looks like Dennis Hall. Let's see who makes the catch. Dennis Hall makes the catch, and he's going to move the football into Aggie territory at the 44-yard line of A&T, and that's going to be a gain of about 8 yards and make it third down now and about 3 to go for a Rattler first down.
Yeah, Dennis Hall, Keith, actually comes from a Pahokee program that loves to throw the football. The first time I saw Dennis Hall actually was on ESPNU. They were playing Burns of South Carolina, and he had a tremendous game that day with over 10 catches.
All right, here we go. Hall comes in motion to set the coverage. Damian Fleming swings this pass. Boy, that's a great defensive play there by Devontae Grant, the linebacker. Hall was open as he came on the underneath, but Graham ran the pass down and batted it down. It's going to bring up fourth down and 3 to go for Rattler first down.
And again, the Aggie defense, which is rated the third best in the conference, holds the Rattlers without a first down.
Colby Blanton on the punt. Devontae Graham deep to receive for A&T. Good snap. Colby gets the kickoff. A beautiful tight spiral. Graham gets away. This is going to hit and roll into the end zone. And so A&T will begin first and 10 from their own 24:02 to play. And we'll be back after these words from our network sponsors on the Rattler Sports Network.
Palmetto Security Services offers superior knowledge in the security business. Palmetto Security has expanded this expertise into the screening industry. Palmetto Security provides fully trained and screened officers to maintain a secure environment. Our physical security services are designed to provide the maximum protection at events, a business, or in an educational environment. For more information, call 850-329-6596 or on the web at www.pssoffl.com.
And we're back. Lewis Kendall and the Aggies from their own 20. On first down, they give it to Tariq Coyne. The Rattlers stretch the play out, but Coyne breaks the tackle and fights his way to the 29-yard line of A&T, and that's going to be a 9-yard gain on first down and make it second down and 1 to go for A&T.
Yeah, both teams right now trying to get their running games established. That's the longest run of the day, that 9-yarder.
Kendall sets two receivers to the far boundary. Tariq Coyne in the backfield, tight end to the far side. That's a strong side of the formation for A&T. They give it to Coyne. Good bit of play faking, though, by Kendall. And Coyne straight ahead is going to pick up the first down out to the 37-yard line of A&T with 3 minutes and 32 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play. First and 10 Aggies from their own 37-yard line. Lewis Kendall under center, I formation. They give it to Cohen, the I back, and Cohen gets back to the line of scrimmage, but not much more. A host of black jerseys there led by Big Frank Mays.
Yeah, good push right now being shown by the Rattler front as they got good penetration. That play is going to be stopped for no gain. Bring up second down and 10.
Kendall under center this time with Cohen in the backfield. They give it to Cohen, and Cohen on the stretch play has the first down and more. Fights his way into Rattler territory at the FAMU 49, and that's going to be about a 13-yard gain and a first down for A&T. Well, Mike, we got our engineer back. Last week, Jerome Swain was wrestling with a homecoming hangover. But he's live and in full color today.
Got some rest last night, eh?
Oh, Robert says, you know he's in good shape when he comes in fussing that hip, Robert. All right, here we go. Lewis Kendall, new back end for the Aggies. Play action, Kendall wants to pass. Rolls right, throws that pass in, and that pass is caught. That's a good-looking thread of the needle. Daquan Swan makes the catch, 6'1", 206 pounds, redshirt sophomore out of Sanford, North Carolina. And on first down, they're going to get about 6 yards, second down and 4 for the A&T Aggies.
Yeah, another good job of play faking by Lewis Kendall. Hard to tell who had that football as they went with the naked boot.
Receivers to either side. This time, Kendall gives to that new back, Dominique Drake. And Drake, 5'9", a 202-pound redshirt senior out of Mount Gilead, North Carolina. He's going to bring up third down and 1 for A&T. Want to say hi and congratulations to the Taylor County Little Falcons for winning the 2013 Little Championship title for second year in a row, undefeated since September 2011, back-to-back titles. The head coach is Wayne Dunwoody, of course, the Dallas Cowboy fan, and he's headed to Dallas to take over the Cowboys. Somebody needs to. Thank you very much. Here we go. They headed to Drake. He breaks a couple of tackles and drills a Rattler all the way down to the 28-yard line of FAMU. It was John Ojo who eventually made the stop, but that's a good bit of power running by Dominique Drake.
That was an excellent job, Keith. He was hit before he picked up the first down, but he's able to drive forward and pick it up.
First and 10, A&T, ball resting at the Rattler 28-yard line. 37 seconds remaining in the first quarter, and the Aggies now give to a new back in the backfield, Ricky Lewis, 5'9", 187-pound senior out of Greensboro. And he's going to be stopped for a loss on the play. This is the best drive of the afternoon, Mike, so far by either team.
Yeah. Lewis, though, is going to be dropped for a loss on that play as, again, the Rattler front getting good penetration.
Second down and 11 for A&T. Kendall under center gives to Tariq Cohen back in the ballgame, and Cohen fights his way all the way down to the 17-yard line, and that's an Aggie first down.
A great tackle in the back end, though, by John Ojo, Keith, to keep that play from going into the end zone, and that looks like
the Tallahassee, the Aggies of North Carolina A&T leading the Rattlers of FAMU. Kick sails into the end zone for a touchback, and so the Rattlers will begin first and 10 from our own 20-yard line.
I think we get it on the 25.
25-yard line.
Let's give you that A&T defense. On the left end, they have Tyree Hearn. Daniel Penix is the right end. The defensive tackles are James Morris and Mike O'Neill. Linebackers, Devontae Graham, Brian Houston, and Landis Schaffner. Devontae Graham is on one corner, and Ayodeji Olatoye is the left corner. The safety is Isaiah Martin and Travis Crosby. And really, they're going with Schaffner as a linebacker, but he's actually the nickelback.
All right, here we go. Rattlers for the first down and 10 from all 25, 13:53 to play, trailing 7-0. Damian Fleming hands it off to Al-Tariq McBurse, and McBurse fighting for every yard across that 25 up to about the 28-yard line.
That's a three-yard
gain of three, second down and seven to go for FAMU.
Keith, the Rattle offense actually gained 1 yard in the first quarter. We were minus six rushing the football and the 7 yards passing for a total of 1 yard. That is not going to get it.
Yeah, got to get more productivity out of the offense. Here we go. Isolated receiver here to the near side. That looked like Dennis Hall. Then twin receivers to the far side. Fleming looking at a pass. What great execution on this play. Al-Tariq McBurse. And McBurse breaking tackles. Fights his way out to the 43-yard line. That's a Rattler first down. That's a 17-yard pickup. The biggest play of the afternoon so far for the Rattler offense.
And the very first down of the afternoon for the Rattler offense. But it's a good game. Good execution that time on the screen play. And a good tough run by McBurse.
First and 10 Rattlers at our own 42-yard line. 12:51 to play here in the first half. Rattlers trailing 7-0. Beautiful afternoon in Tallahassee, Florida. Not a cloud in the sky. Here we go. Mike Morris, the tight end, flips to the far boundary. Strong side of the formation. Offset eye for Damian Fleming. Now Caleb Brown goes in motion. We give it to McBurse. And McBurse straight ahead, maybe for a yard, but not much more. Second down and nine for FAMU.
Boy, number three, the safety, Isaiah Martin, 5'8", 185-pound senior out of Roanoke, Virginia, stepped up into that hole from his safety spot to hold that to just a two-yard gain.
Mike, speaking of Virginia, we'll be there next week. It's homecoming in Norfolk next week, and the Rattlers are the homecoming opponent for the Norfolk State Spartans.
Yeah, looks like we're doing the MEAC homecoming tour this year.
Yeah. All right, Casey glides wide to the near side, a receiver to the far side, and backs in an offset eye. And this time, Damian, play action, throws downfield, and it's going to be incomplete. Defending back there for the Aggies was Devontae Graham. That pass was intended.
By number 80,
Victor Love.
Yep. And Coach Holmes mentioned Victor Love at the press conference, saying that he might be getting more playing. 6'5", only 175 pounds, a freshman out of Orlando's Oak Ridge.
Third down now, and about nine to go for a Rattler first down. Third down and nine for FAMU. Ball's resting at our own 44-yard line. Let's see if we can't convert on this possession play. Damian Fleming takes the snap, rolls right, looking to deliver a short pass, but the pass was thrown short, and it's going to bring up fourth down for the Rattlers.
Well, the Rattlers were able to change field position, Keith. They pushed it out near midfield and have a chance now to pin the Aggies back deep in their own territory. They did pick up their initial first down of the game on that drive.
Kobe Blanton on the punt, and Devontae Graham, deep to receive.
There's a little kid down there with one of the cutest orange and green outfits I think I've ever seen.
This kick is going to sail out of bounds. And let's see, the Aggies will have the football first down and 10 from their own 28-yard line. They lead 7-11, 25 to play. Well, Mike, Coach Holmes was talking about first wide receiver Dennis Hall, too, on Tuesday at the press conference. He said, here's a guy that was, they almost didn't let him come back to camp. And he made him stand up last week after last week's game in the team meeting to say that this guy had really worked hard to, you know, just get some playing time.
Yeah, and he's a guy, Keith, that once you get your opportunity, you got to do something with it. And I think that's the main thing. He's taking advantage of his opportunity.
All right, here we go. They hand it off to Dominique Drake. And Drake comes barreling through across the 35, down to about the 37-yard line.
Yeah, and the Rattler nose guard, Keith, got manhandled on that
second
play.
Yeah, second down and one. for FAMU.
Yeah, second down and one. And boy, we've seen a lot of I formation and two tight end sets out of A&T as they have gone with a power look. Ball's going to be handed off to Cohen. He's going to be hit, but he's going to fall forward across the 40-yard line. He's going to have another A&T first down.
First down for A&T. 10:44 to play in the first half, and the Aggies leading 7-0.
Looks like the little wind that was blowing has died down, and, well, we're really comfortable. Out here in the beautiful sunshiny Bragg Stadium.
Yeah, and to give some of the students credit, that section has picked up a little bit. All right, here we go. Kendall hands off to Cohen. He's going to be trapped behind the line of scrimmage this time and dropped. And it's big Frank Mays and William Smalls again, Mike, on the tackle for the Rams.
Yeah, Frank Mays, he's 6'10", 295 pounds. He's only 6'10". Defensive player, I know. There's one offensive tackle who's about that size. But he does a great job of staying low. He's a big guy, but he bends well. He's got a good future in front of him.
All right, here we go. Rattlers bringing the blitz this time. Kendall sets up the pass, fires way down. We've got a man down there and just overthrows the intended receiver. But some good defensive play back there, too, by Terry Johnson.
Yeah, the A&T receiver had a step, but instead of running through the ball, he's tried to stop and jump, and it's going to sail over his head incomplete, bring up a third down and long now.
Actually, it was Darren Parker, Mike, not Terry Johnson, defending on that play. That's good defense by Darren Parker. And, Mike, it's important that we talk about Darren Parker because he's a freshman out of Miami, Florida, and Quint and Coach Earl Holmes had said, you know, the young players look like they want to play and do something, so he's going to let them play. Third down and 10 now for A&T. Kendall sets up the pass, fires this pass, overthrows the intended receiver, who was Desmond Lawrence out of Durham, North Carolina. And so it's going to bring a fourth down for the Aggies of North Carolina A&T. And Dominic Frescura will check on the punt, and it will be Trayvon Holmes deep to receive for the Rattlers of FAMU. Tight short kick this time from Frescura. Holmes steps away from it, and it's going to roll dead at about the 18-yard line of the Rattlers, and the Rattlers will begin first and 10 from there. Timeout on the field, 9:27 to play. Aggies leading 7-0. We'll be back after these words from our local sponsors on the Rattlers Sports Network.
FAMU Boosters are a very special group of Rattlers. They are people who love the school and love those Rattler sports teams. The Boosters are me, and they are you. We're the only group that's sanctioned to raise money for the athletic department. Only the Boosters can give you parking in Bragg Stadium. Boosters not only buy season tickets, but they give from their hearts to make the teams better. They are those orange and green wearing and making people in Bragg Stadium parking lot with their reserved individualized parking and the names in the Strike magazine. They come early to every home game and bother everyone not sporting their orange and green. When you meet a Rattler Booster, you're meeting a proud supporter of the legendary FAMU sports program. You are meeting someone who's putting their money where their Rattler heart is. Someone who's giving at a level that is more than season ticket, more than a parking space, but someone who's giving extra because they want to make a difference. Join the FAMU Rattler Boosters, one of the strongest and largest booster groups in HBCU sports. We are FAMU. Would you expect anything else? Call a booster office at 850-224-6093. Rattler Boosters, mission of tradition.
Rattlers hand the football off on first down and pick up second down 2 yards. Second down, about 8 to go for a Rattler first down. And Casey Glines is going to come wide to the near boundary for FAMU. In the backfield for the Rattlers with his Al-Tariq McBurst. This pass is caught by Glines, and Glines going to be tossed out of bounds at about the 36-yard line. But that's a Rattler first down, and that'll move the chains.
And that was a good job of pass protection, Keith. No pressure on Damian Fleming, able to hit his receiver, Casey Glines, and That was a good-looking offensive play. Picks up their second first down of the ball game.
Rattlers with the first and 10 now from our own 35-yard line. Heading right to left, or heading toward that north end zone with 8:30 to play. Isolated receiver over here near side. That's Dennis Hall. Twins to the far boundary. Wing.
Oh my goodness.
A high snap.
Well, he's got to get on that football.
And, this is going to be a legal procedure. I guess we had two men in motion. Snapped the ball over the quarterback's head. There was a whole lot of confusion on that play.
Yeah, and I'm not sure the officials should have blown that play dead, because it actually was going to be an illegal shift call. But luckily for the Rattlers, the whistle was blown. So we only lose 5 yards, and actually we get to keep the down.
Yeah, in fact, we should thank those officials for calling that play dead. As many times we've been critical, we appreciate that.
Yes, sir.
8:15 to go in the first half, 7-0. The Aggies lead. Wing right this time. And Twins to the far boundary for Damian Fleming. We run the draw play, and boy, the Aggies just a jailbreak up front. And they immediately tackle the Rattler running back, Al Tariq McBurge. He's going to be dropped for a loss. And it's going to bring up second down and about 20 yards to go for Rattler first down. Ball's resting back at the Rattler 25.
Yeah, the Rattler running game not going anywhere. Rudy Randolph back behind the stadium, keep serving up some good seafood. He was a wing back for us. I think he could have done a little bit better on that play. Would have gained a few more yards.
Yeah, Reggie Seals and his wife cooking up that good barbecue too, Mike. Hello. Boy, they had so much business last week, Mike. They sold out in the third quarter. Here we go, Damian Fleming spinning and turning. This is a good-looking run from Damian. He turns and gets out of bounds at about the 32-yard line, so he cuts some of that deficit in half, and it's going to bring up third down now for the Rattlers and about 13 yards to go for a first down. So he's going to get about 7 of those yards back against that 20.
Great escape by Damian, who was surrounded in the pocket, did a little spin move and got outside. Credit him for all of that Rattler pickup. Yo, Reggie, a little Ayana back there.
Yep. That's always the place to go if you need that fix before the game. Ask Sean, well, he was chowing down on those ribs. Third down at 13, Damian Fleming sets up. Wants to pass, fires, got a man open, but overthrows the intended receiver. That was Dwayne Harvey, and it's going to bring up fourth down for the Ramblers. Mike, Quinn Gray was concerned about his offense. He left the press box, went down on the sideline to try and talk to his offensive unit.
And let's hope that's not a communications problem, because we were plagued with a communications problem where the headphones went out earlier this year.
Colby Blanton on the punt, and it's Devontae Graham deep to receive for the Aggies, who lead it 7-0, 6:39 to play in the first half. High kick. Graham gets away from it. It takes sort of an Aggie roll, then rolls backwards, takes a Rattler roll, and it's going to be downed at about the 28-yard line, where the Aggies will begin first and 10 from there.
Yeah, that ball might have rolled a little bit further.
All right, we'll be back after these words from our local sponsors on the Rattler Sports Network. right, now Aggies ran the jet sweep on first down, lost a yard, second down, and 11 to go. They give it, no, Kendall Keeks on a quarterback option. And boy, he is nailed over there by Brandon Denmark. But he's going to pick up a couple of yards and make it third down now, about 7 yards to go for the Aggies of A&T.
Now, Brandon Denmark, he has got an outstanding younger brother. Plays wide receiver out at Tallahassee. Rickers, a really good-looking prospect. Hopefully he'll follow his brother up here to the hill.
5:24 to play here in the first half. 7-0 A&T, and Lewis Kendall fires this pass downfield. A battle for it. Good defense over there.
It's going to bring up fourth down.
Darren Parker again defending on the play. Fourth down for A&T. And once again, Mike, the Rattler defense playing pretty well here this afternoon. We can get something going offensively.
Got to get something going.
Yeah, and Keith and Mike, one of the assistant coaches, one of the fired up faces is none other than George Small, who is pretty happy about the way his defense has been performing. Of course, he has vested interest in this game because he had his A&T ties. He was head coach of A&T from 2003 to 2005, so he was definitely fired up for this game. And you see his defense is pretty fired up as well.
All right, Frescura gets the kickoff. And Terry Johnson scoops it up, 45 midfield, and scoops out of bounds in Aggie territory at about the 40. They're going to mark him out of bounds at, looks like, right at midfield. And Elton not only was Coach Smalls, the former head coach of A&T, he's an A&T grad.
Yeah, yeah, he played. As well as a nice little NFL career.
Yeah. So it's first down for the Rattlers. Mark the football at our own 49-yard line. It's excellent field position on that return by Terry Johnson. Damian Fleming, wing left, sends his tight end. That's Morris to the far side, strong side of the formation. And Fleming wants to pass, throws the quick out. And it's caught over there by Admason Felix. Like, you know, for most of his career, we've been calling him Adamson Felix because that's how he was listed in all of the information that came out from FAMU. But his name is really Admason Felix.
And we found that out because he was at the Tuesday press conference and had to introduce himself when we heard him say Admason.
And we apologized to him, Mike, for calling him Adamson Felix for all this time. He said, "Nah, it's cool. I knew what y'all were doing." Here we go, second down, about 3 to go for the Rattlers. Ad Mason picks up 7 yards on that reception. We got illegal procedure called against the Rattlers.
Looks like everybody knew the snap count except the center. I want to say hi to Gene, Sam, Kelton, Tommy, all the folks over in Rich Bay. They're listening to the ball game on 96.1.
And I want to say hi to Mr. Clifford Swain. October 25th, Mike, he celebrated his 88th birthday. That's outstanding. Wayne, I want you to know that everything is okay. Jerome's sitting here doing all the right things. Everything is good. Well, Mr. Swain, be concerned. He want to make sure everything's all right. It's all right. Here we go, second down and 7 to go. And Damian Fleming's pass incomplete. That's good defense there by Devontae Grant. It's going to bring up third down, about 7 to go. I want to say hi to Taylor and Taylor, listening in on the big station 96.1. And then Lorian way out at San Diego on iHeartRadio, and Corbin up in New York, and Kristen right here in Tallahassee. I want to say hi to all the listeners who have tuned in to the broadcast today on the Rattler Sports Network.
On iHeartRadio and on your computer.
Yeah, a lot of different ways to follow the Rattlers. Third down and 7. Well, as our good friend Jimmy Kimble used to say, Mike, don't follow me, follow the Rattlers. Timeout on the field, and we'll be back after these words from our network sponsors, the near side, Aggies threatening blitz, and they back it off. Damian decides to run. He's going to pick up the first down. At the 39-yard line of the Aggies. That's a good-looking run by the junior quarterback out of Jacksonville.
Yeah, that's a design run, Keith. That was quarterback draw all the way. Took a step back and then followed his fullback up into the hole. And this, Keith, could be the deepest penetration for the Rattlers on the afternoon.
All First and 10, Rattlers. The ball resting at the Aggie 38-yard line. Rattlers send triplets to the far boundary. Isolate Harvey over here near side. They hand it off, though, to James. Oh, that's Lamon Bice. And, boy, Bice has a whole pile trying to bring him down. He fights his way to the 29-yard line of A&T. I like that Lamon Bice, Mike.
He actually moved the pile about 5 yards, Keith. He made first contact at about the 35-yard line. He's going to push down to about the 32. It's going to be second down and only three.
Yeah, Lamon Bice, he bringing the light-skinned brothers back, man. He ran with some authority. Well, he is.
They're trying to reset the game clock. It right now shows 3:11.
Casey glides wide to the near side. It's going to be Dwayne Harvey over here to the near.
Yeah.
Now, glides to the far side, Harvey to the near side.
With one-on-one coverage over there on glides.
Yeah, two tight ends, too. This is a power play. Bice in the backfield. Third down, about four to go. And Lamon Bice, this is a tailor-made play for him. Let's see. Bice gets the call. He bounces outside. Maybe, boy, almost bounced a little too far that time. Should have gone more north and south than east and west. Yeah. Penalty markers on the play, though.
Penalty markers came in as he was going down. Don't know whether they're going to get somebody for holding or whether there was a face mask because the referee threw his flag.
Two flags on the
and
play.
Then one came from the back judge.
All right, get Michael Morris, the tight end for holding.
And I think you were right, Keith. He had an opportunity to make his one cut, and he tried to bounce it outside a little bit too far, causes his tight end, Michael Morris, to get caught for holding.
Yeah. Lamon Bice, Mike, is not an east and west runner. He's a north and south. And that's where he gets his power.
Yeah, and his cutback lane was there. And I think that's what they're talking to him about now on the sideline.
Casey Glines comes wide near side. And Flip Harvey to the far side. Tight end near side. Now that's strong side of the formation. And it's James Owens in the backfield. Boy, Damian running for his life and just throws this one away. That's an accident. That might have been a smart play, Mike, because that's about all he could do on that one.
A linebacker came free right up the middle. Right in the face of Damian. He had to roll out of the pocket and try to get the ball downfield somewhere. If you or someone you know is a victim of domestic violence, call the domestic violence hotline at 1-800-799-7233. That's 1-800-799-SAFE. You might save a life, and that is mine for a LaToya moment.
Yeah, I'm glad you're doing that every game. That's important. Third down, about 13 to go now for the Rattlers. Ball's resting at the Aggie 42-yard line. 2 minutes and 32 seconds to play. We need to get something going here. There's timeout taken on the field.
Rattlers with the football in the shotgun formation, four wide and one back in the backfield. Damian Freeman comes out. He tries to throw a quick screen. That pass is going to bounce off the hands of the intended receiver. It was almost intercepted. It's going to bring up fourth down. And with 2:27 to go here before halftime, the Rattlers will try to pin the Aggies back deep in their own territory for this final 2 minutes. Kobe Blanton is on to do the punting. Back to return the punt, Devontae Graham, out of Tallahassee Lincoln, 5'10", 160-pounder. Blanton gets off a high spiraling kick. Graham is under it, and he's going to make the fair. No, he didn't call for the fair catch. He made that catch in a crowd. The Rattlers stood as though he had made the fair catch signal. But, boy, on the tackle now, Devontae Graham is down.
And, yeah, he got knocked out. Breaking the action, timeout on the field. He's lead 7-0, and Devontae Graham up and off the field, Mike, because looks like he just got the wind knocked out of him.
He got something knocked out of him.
All right, Aggie set to go. First down to 10. Ball is resting at their own 25-yard line, moving left to right. And Kendall hands it off to Tariq Cohen, cuts back. And that's Akil Blunt, who wraps him up and holds him until some more black jerseys get there. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Rattlers Sports Network. shuttling players in on second down and about 7 yards to go for A&T. Kendall takes the snap, fires this pass. Looks like the pass may have been partially deflected. It's going to bring up third down, about 7 to go for the Aggies.
Yep, the pass was wide, and if the Rattlers can hold right here, we can get the football back. Still a minute 32 on the clock before halftime.
I want to say hi to Dawn and Sylvia Smith down in Boynton Beach. And Kirkland and Delbert Floyd, all the Floyd clan down in South Florida, all tuned in, checking us out. And here we go. Third down and 7 for the Aggies. They give it to Cohen. Boy, Cohen broke a tackle, but it was Terry Johnson came up to put a shoulder on him, a secure tackle.
Got a timeout.
And the Rattlers take time. Minute 25 remaining in the first half. We'll be back after these words. My local smart. And Trayvon, actually, it looks like Terry Johnson deep to receive for the Rattlers on this punt. Going to drive Terry all the way back to the 15-yard line. 20, 25, 30, 35, and Terry down at a 39-yard line. That's an excellent return by Devontae Terry Johnson out of Tallahassee Rickards.
Yeah, with the addition of Terry Keith being able to return punts, that really ups his stock as we might see Terry playing on Sundays.
Yeah. Outstanding athlete, Mike. And got a good head on his shoulders, too.
Won a state championship in basketball under Coach Eli Bryant. Out at Rickards.
The Rickards Raiders. No longer the Redskins. Been a big debate about that in the NFL,
politically,
right?
Correct, yes.
Damian Fleming's pass tossed out there. It's intended for Ad Mason Felix.
As out of Olatoye with a great
break on the ball.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
Second down and 10. Rattlers were fortunate that he didn't pick that one off. Brings up a second down and 10 for the Rattlers. Ball's resting at our own 39-yard line with a minute 12 to play in the first half. Damian Fleming. Twins to the far boundary, and Dwayne Harvey over here near side. Fleming fires down, got a man open, and boy, the pass was a little high. That's how you get your receiver broke up there.
Yeah, but that ball's got to be caught, Keith. It was thrown on a line, and that looks like Victor Love. The ball hit his hands.
Yeah, Travis Crosby was defending on the play for the A&T Aggies.
Yeah, you got the big fella. He's only 177 pounds at 6'5". You got to come down with that catch. Third down now and 10 as the Rattlers stay aggressive. Minute 4 remaining here before halftime. We need a first down.
All right, Rattlers go. Twins to either side in a spread formation. And James Owens in the backfield. Damian pulls it down. Dancing around, trying to find an open receiver. And Damian now fires a pass down there for Casey Klein. And it falls incomplete. But Mike gives the A&T defense some credit on that. That's the coverage. That's good coverage downfield by the Aggie secondary.
Yeah, they only rushed 3 and they dropped 8. So although Damian had time, there were a lot of people back there in coverage. They did a good job of staying with the Rattler receivers. And they force a punt with 50 seconds to go.
Yeah, Colby Blanton on the punt for the Rattlers. And it's Devontae Graham, deep to receive for A&T. 50 seconds remaining in the first half, 7-0, the Aggies lead. Colby gets off a high punt. Graham calls for the fair catch. It takes a Rattler roll, but he called for the fair catch. And he started off running, but that's going to be down at the 22-yard line of A&T.
Yeah, he called for the fair catch, and after the ball hit the ground and bounced, he thought he had a pretty good lane over here, tried to run it, but the officials blow the whistle with only 40 seconds to go. Probably won't see the Aggies too aggressive here. Probably want to get to halftime with the 7-0 lead.
Keith and Mike, I was watching the FAMU defensive staff, and Coach Kirkland was really getting on his players, saying you can't just sit back and wait for somebody to do something. You have to go out there and take it. He was urging his players to go out and make a play on defense to get this game back in the FAMU favor.
All right, Lewis Kendall takes a knee. And yeah, Mike, you're right. The Aggies are going to be content to take a 7-0 lead into the locker room at halftime.
Yeah, they don't have to snap it again either. There's 34 seconds on the play clock, only 24 on the game clock. So they're just going to let it run down. That's going to be the last play. As a matter of fact, both teams are headed on to the locker room.
All right, so the Aggies will take a 7-0 lead into the locker room at the half. And our Elton Gumbel is going to try and talk to Coach Earl Holmes as he makes his way toward the locker room. So we'll go down to Elton and
FAMU down 7-0, but Coach Holmes thinks.
We also encourage our fans today to wear pink in addition to the orange and the green in our recognition of Breast Awareness Month. You all know that through the College of Pharmacy and Pharmacy Clinical Sciences, we have a center of excellence designed to cannabis research, training, and community service in our efforts to eradicate this hideous disease. We also today want to give thanks to the young men and women who serve in our nation's armed forces. From the first rifle to being recognized this year by Connie Stanley as one of the top
scholars
for young men and women who are pursuing careers in military service. FAMU has a rich history in preparing young men and women for military service. These just are a few of the great things that happen at FAMU every day. And now, when the dark clouds gather on the horizon, when thunder and lightning fill the sky, when fate is but a glint in the eye of a fallen rascal, and hope are lost friends, when the FAMU of the chest grows weary from those hard-charging linebackers, and the muscles in the legs grow tired from those hard-charging running backs, you must always remember that the Rattlers will strike and strike and strike again.
Thus you stand. Congratulations to FAMU men and women's cross-country team for winning both the BAC championships this morning in Maryland. You call that a repeat.
Christian, give me the military coach. I'm not coming down. No, go back to drum major, Christian. Go back to drum major.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. From the highest of Seven Hills, the capital of Florida, please welcome what has not only become known as America's band, but also one of the most exciting marching bands in the world, the return of the incomparable, magnificent, fabulous, and fantastic Florida A&M University Marching Band. This special halftime presentation dedicated to all those who have served in any any capacity the United States of America Armed Forces. We salute you with this Armed Force dedication. The theme show, all information, were charted by future music educators in Dr. Shelby Chipman's instrumental methods and technique class.
All Marine veterans. the baton in the hands of our director, Dr. Sylvester Young. Please enjoy our continued salute to America with America the Beautiful. It has been 95 years since the guns fell silent at the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month of 1918, ending World War I, the war that was supposed to end all wars. And so the 100 today pays honor to the men and women who, down through all the decades, on blooded swords and forsaken posts on these shores and abroad, have served to protect and defend the United States. The country has 23 million vets who owe thanks for their sacrifices, whether they fought in the snow of Europe and the jungles of the Pacific long ago. In the bleakness of Korea, in the forbidden parts of Vietnam, or in the sand and dust of this modern era conflicts. And we owe more than gratitude for the wonderfully waving flags and parades that have grown so popular. We must do more, particularly for the 2.4 million who went bravely to Iraq and Afghanistan and survived to come home. This performance is dedicated to the men and women who have to continue to place their lives on the line for the United States of America. And for all those who have given their lives for our freedom throughout America's history, we should also acknowledge the families of our veterans who have sacrificed along with them. In 1954, November 11th was the official name for Veterans Day. Then President Dwight D. Eisenhower called upon all citizens to join hands in a common purpose to remember the sacrifice of all of us. Well, on the seas, in the air, and on foreign shores, to preserve our heritage of freedom. Our troops have always served our country with dedication. They have defended America in major conflicts, including World Wars I and II, Korea, Vietnam, the Gulf War, the Iraq, and Afghan wars. They've also defended us in smaller amounts around the world, such as in Somalia, Bosnia, and Iraq. And today we should look our President, Barack Obama, for his leadership to bring our active service members home. And our armed forces veterans deserve our thanks for this upcoming Veterans Day and every day of the year. To the house. Thank you.
Bill Baker, Mr. FAMU Ronnie Mackey Jr., Ms. Graduate Attendant Ashley Lipscomb, Ms. Senior Attendant Brianna Hill, Ms. Junior Attendant Tiandria Hood, Ms. Sophomore Attendant Anquinette Taylor, Ms. Freshman Attendant Amberly Williams, Queen of Orange and Green Janae Thompson, King of Orange and Green Kevin Lee, Mr. Anthony Siders, 2013-14 Student Government Association President and member of the Florida A&M University Board of Trustees.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the Florida University alma mater, conducted by Dr. Sheila L. James, Director of Percussion and Senior Marching Band Staff Member.
Chase Bonador kicks it off, and here come the Aggies out to about the 26-yard line. That's Desmond Lawrence. A&T will begin first and 10 from there. Let's reset the Aggie offense. Lawrence at the wide receiver position. William Robinson is the left tackle. Donye Gurrell is the left guard. Ronald Canty, the center. Timothy Sutkins is the right guard. Nathan Isles, the right tackle. And Devin Moore is the tight end. Tariq Cohen has been the workhorse at running back. Lewis Kendall has gone all the way today at quarterback. Anthony McMinn, the second, is the fullback, and Darren Bullock is the other wide receiver. Kendall sets, twins to the far boundary, and this time play action rolls that way, dumps it out to his big fullback, Devin Moore, or the tight end, 6 foot, 264-pound senior out of Charlotte, North Carolina. And that's good Rattler defense, going to stop him for no gain on the play. Second down and 10 for A&T.
Tariq Cohen was the workhorse for the A&T Aggies in the first half. He had 73 yards and 12 carries. Kendall Lewis held to only one of six passes for a mere 5 yards. So the Rattlers doing good defense in the secondary.
Just got to get something going offensively, Mike. All right, here we go. Lewis Kendall this time on a quarterback option. Now pitches to Cohen. Cohen breaks the tackle and spins forward and looks like he's going to have enough to move the chains and give the Aggies a first down.
The first half for the Rattlers. Al Tariq McBurst ended up being the leading rusher, 15 yards on 5 carries. James Owens had 14 on 2. As the Rattlers able to produce only 58 yards of total offense in the first half. Damian Fleming, 5 of 15 for 37 yards. Leading tackle for the Rattlers, Frank Mays and John Ojo for the A&T Aggies, Devontae Grant and Brian Houston.
Lewis Kendall this time. Boy, bad snap. And Kendall does the alert thing, just falls on the football. They're going to lose about 5 yards on that play, make it first down and 15 now for A&T.
Yeah, seems to the A&T Aggies since halftime sort of self-destructing here offensively. Neither team did a lot. It was a defensive struggle. And the first team that can put a little something together offensively, Keith's going to come out of here with a win.
Yeah. Aggies moving right to left as we begin the second half of play. Backs in the I formation, and Lewis Kendall sets up, wants to pass. Oh, he got pressure, takes away from a couple of Rattlers, pulls it down, he's going to run. Kendall dives forward to the 40-yard line.
They were holding.
But there's a penalty marker on the play, and it's going to be holding against A&T.
Yeah, they were holding back behind the play.
So the Aggies going to get backed up even more. The infraction was called on the right tackle, Nathan Isles, 6'5", 324-pound senior out of Atlanta, Georgia. And so the Aggies now going to be faced with a second down. About 25, 26 yards to go for a first down. And Lewis Kendall this time is going to go under center, with receivers to either side and an I formation. Rattlers bringing blitz. They give it to Cohen, and Cohen fights his way to the 25-yard line. That's a 4-yard gain, which will make it third down and about 22 to go now for A&T.
The Rattlers have been getting good pressure up front, Keith. Mainly big Frank Mays getting a good push from that nose guard spot. The Rattlers bringing their top pass rushers in Sean Ward and Curtis Alexander.
Yep, third down and 22 for the Aggies. Kendall with two backs. He lines up in the gun, looks to pass, sets up, fires over the middle, and boy, that pass was intended for Desmond Lawrence, but he was upended.
Ojo.
By John Ojo.
Ojo was
up. Ojo Mike was laying another last week. He's bringing it again this week.
Yes, doing a good job at that free safety spot.
Fourth down for the Aggies. Now we send in Dominic Frescura to punt. And it's going to be Devontae Terry Johnson deep to receive for the Rattlers. Well, he gets off a good kick. Terry Johnson calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 33-yard line. And so the Rattlers will begin our first possession of the second half from there with 11:51 to play in the third quarter. And the score, FAMU nothing, A&T 7. We'll be back after these words from our network sponsors on the Rattler Sports Network.
The Rattler Boosters would like to thank the following premium givers who have made significant contributions to the Rattler Boosters. Super Boosters, Palmetto Security Services, Super Rattler Boosters, Law Office of Ted M. Taylor, Rudy Maxwell, Keith and Misha Stubbs, Strike Level Boosters, Carmen Blody Jones, Dorothy P. Williams, Fred and Beverly Gaines, Lawton Williams, Lloyd and Ella Cobbs, Maurice S. Pickett, Rodney Clayton, Sullivan and Sharon Cobb, and Metron Contract.
On first down, the Rattlers hand it off to Al Tariq McBurst. Well, actually, let's check that.
24.
Yes, Lamont Vice, and Vice fights forward for about 3, second down and 7 for the Rattlers.
I'll give a shout out to my man, Victor Davis, listening in on 96.1. the folks over in Bond, the Bond community.
Second and seven. Rattlers handed off to Bice again, trying to be patient and follow his blocks, but he's going to lose maybe a yard on this one. Make a third down. And about eight to go for a Rattler first down. Who's working the board today? Mike's Doc Foster. Yeah, I want to say hi to Doc Foster over at 96.1, working that board and doing an outstanding job as usual. Doc. Hey, third down and eight. Go ahead, Elton, I'm sorry.
No, Keith and Mike, all I was saying is that we had a pretty healthy game, healthy first half, but I can give you a medical update. The entire FAMU coaching staff has pink ribbons on their shirts for breast cancer awareness, and former FSU safety Myron Roll is part of the FAMU sports medicine staff right now. He may be an intern or something along those lines, but he is with the staff on the sidelines at FAMU.
All right, that pass is caught, and he's going to move the chains for a Rattler first down. Dennis Hall. Oh, Lamon Bice on the receiving end of that pass. So Bice might do a double duty, running with power and catching passes now, too.
And give Damian Fleming credit, Keith, for keeping that play alive until somebody could break open, throwing that ball under the rest accurately.
All right, first down and 10 for the Rattlers. Ball's resting at our own 46-yard line. Rattlers are moving left to right as we begin this second half of play. Rattlers send a man in motion. And toss this pass out here to Casey Glines. And Casey's going to fight his way to about the 49-yard line. That should be a gain of about three. Make it second down and about seven to go for a Rattler first down.
The Aggies have one of their corners only 5'8". The other is 6'1". And the 6'1 corner goes wherever the 6'6 Casey Glines goes.
Second down and seven for the Rattlers. Ball's resting at our own 49-yard line with 9:26 to play. 7-0 Aggies. Damian Fleming this time looks to pass, throws the underneath, and overthrows the intended receiver.
That's Mike Morris. Ball hit his hands. Got to come down with those.
Yeah. The tight end, Mike Morris.
Leaves the Rattlers with another third and long at 37.
Morris, 6'4", 230, a redshirt freshman out of Jacksonville. Played his high school football over there at Andrew Jackson, Mike. Third down at seven for the Rattlers. 9:15 to go here in the third quarter. Aggies leading 7-0. Rattlers spread out the formation this time with twin receivers to either side. Lamon Bice in the backfield.
Here comes the blitz.
Fleming going, got a man downfield. Oh! Hit him in the hands, but can't hold on.
That looked like the freshman, Montavious Williams.
It's Dennis Hall.
Or was it Dennis Hall?
Dennis Hall. Right on the hands, and he couldn't bring it in. So it's going to bring up fourth down for the Rattlers. That's another catchable ball, Mike.
That is another catchable ball, and well, you got to give your quarterback some help.
Colby Blanchard on the punt. Devontae Graham deep to receive for the Aggies. What a beautiful punt by Colby. This is going to hit in the end zone, and the Aggies are bringing out. Timeout in Tallahassee. 7-0, A&T leads, and we'll be back after these words from our network sponsors. The Rattler Sports Network.
Hey, FAMU fans. New coach Earl Holmes has the Rattlers ready to strike, and the Marching 100 is back. It's Fall Frenzy time in Tallahassee. From Friday night fun to relaxing Sunday brunch, Fall Frenzy adds to the excitement of FAMU game day. Discover the rich history of African-American culture at the FAMU Black Archives, Riley House Museum, and the Knott House Museum. Go to visittallahassee.com and find out all about Fall Frenzy events. And go Rattlers!
Aggies set to go, first and 10 from their own 20. 8:59 to play in the third quarter. They give it to Cohen. And Cohen is slapped to the turf. Frank Mays is one of the Rattler tacklers. The other one is Akil Blunt. And Mike, Akil Blunt having a phenomenal sophomore season.
He is. No sophomore slump for him. He's picking it right up from where he was last year and actually going forward.
Yeah, gain of about four, second down and six for A&T. Lewis Kendall sends twin receivers to the far boundary. He has Cohen in the backfield, And the tight end lines up on the far side. That's the strong side of that formation. Kendall fires over there. That pass deflected. Almost picked off, too, Mike. Let's see, it was a Rattler linebacker got his hands on it. Looks like it was Bobby Jackson. Bobby Jackson could have had him a pick, Mike.
Did a good job of knocking that ball away, though. Third down and medium. Rattlers go with their dime package as the Aggies send in more wide receivers.
Yeah. A&T sends in three receivers and a new running back. Dominique Drake is the running back that checked in on third down and seven for A&T. Lewis Kendall with a spread formation steps up in the pocket. Boy, he's chased by a lot of right. That pass is picked off. And going in for the score.
Sean Ward.
Sean Ward. Mike has been stepping up his play.
Lewis Kendall was in trouble keeping from the very beginning. I think it was Brandon Denmark who first broke away and caused the pressure. But it's Sean Ward who gets the tip interception out of Fort Lauderdale, Florida and Texas A&M. And he is going to rumble about 15 yards, and the Rattlers are an extra point from tying this ball game up.
That's a touchdown for Florida A&M. Chase Bonador on for the extra point, and it's good. 8:03 to play in the third quarter. The Rattlers have tied it up. It's 7-7 in Bragg Stadium, and we'll be back after these words from our network sponsors from the Rattlers Sports Network. So, and returns it about 15 yards for the score. Chase Bonador adds the extra point. We're all tied up in Tallahassee at 7 apiece. Here's the kick. Boy, Rattlers trying to force the return man deeper, and he goes down. That's Tony McRae out of Laurinburg, North Carolina. He's gonna get back to the about the 16-yard, huh?
No, that looks like they're gonna spot it about the
13-yard line. Well, the Aggies will begin first and 10 from there. It's a whole new ball game now, Mike, at 7 apiece.
It was the ferociousness of the Rattler pressure that caused all the problems right there.
Here we go, Aggies first down and 10 from their own 13. Twins to the near boundary, backs in the eye. They give it to the eye back. Let's see if that's Cohen or if that's Drake. Dominique Drake was the ball carrier. He's gonna get about four. Second down and six to go for A&T. Xavier Griffin is the isolated receiver. No, they sent a receiver to either side. Griffin goes to the far boundary, and Bullock is wide to the near side. Backs again in the I formation. And here we go. They give it to, is this Drake?
Good run by Drake.
Yeah. Dominique Drake's going to pick up the first down as Drake gets about 7 yards on that carry. 7:15 to play in the third quarter. And we're tied at 7 apiece. Lewis Kendall, two back set. Twins to the far boundary. Rattlers bringing the blitz, but they hand it off to Tariq Cohen. And Cohen's going to slash his way for about 8, maybe 9 yards. Actually, he's going to get 10 yards. That's a first down on first down.
Yeah, and the Aggies got a couple first downs now. Now they're trying to go with tempo.
This time they give it to Cohen again. He's at the point of attack and breaking tackles and fights his way for it. Looks like another Aggie first down.
It was Michael Lovejoy who had him in the backfield. He's going to break away, and he's going to have another first down. And quickly now, A&T has moved out to the Rattler 47.
No, to the Aggie 47.
The Aggie 47.
Yeah. But they're moving.
And Keith and Mike, that's exactly what head coach Earl Holmes was trying to guard against. When Sean Ward had the pick six, he immediately went over to his defense while they were still celebrating and told him to stay focused.
All right, here we go. Option play. Oh, man. He had him in the backfield. He breaks the tackle. Cohen,
oh, there's a block in the back.
40, 35. And now the play disintegrates as their penalty markers all over the field. As they like to say, it's a lot of laundry out there.
Yeah, and Frank Mays over here, Keith, seems to be injured. He was the rattler who had the running back in the backfield, but certainly the flags are going to be for a block in the back.
Frank Mays is down. Here comes the rattler training crew. Yeah, there's a lot of laundry out there on the field. It's timeout here on the field, 6:21. And well, that is Lewis again around left corner.
Yeah, and we should have had another holding call on that one too, Keith. The official sort of felt for his flag and decided not to throw it. It's going to bring up a third down and short as, again, they run the stretch play to the outside.
Yeah, third down, about three to go for A&T. 5:28 to play in the third quarter. We're tied at seven. And it's third down and three for A&T.
Keith and Mike, following up on Frankie Mays' injury, they are right now icing his left shin. Left shin for Frankie Mays.
All right, here we go. Kendall, high snap, but he gives it to Lewis. And Lewis stiffs on a Rattler defender. And looks like he'll have enough for the first down.
Yeah, good stiff arm that time by the running back. He's going to gain him some extra yards. He's going to have a first down. As suddenly the A&T offense seems to be getting in gear.
Yeah. Tariq Cohen checks back in, replacing Lewis after Lewis gets the first down. With 5 minutes and 2 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Seven apiece. FAMU seven, A&T seven. And the Aggies send Darryl Bullock to the far boundary. Desmond Lawrence over here to the near side. They give it to Cohen. And Cohen trying to find some running room. Run slap into Akil Blunt, who drives him out of bounds at the Rattler 39-yard line. That Akil Blunt, Mike, is a sure tackle.
Yeah, I was about to say the same thing, Key. He doesn't miss very many tackles when he gets to the scene.
Yeah, they're going to pick up about 3 yards. It'll be second down and seven to go. 4:35 to play in the third, seven apiece. Pull up to the far side, and Lawrence over here near side. Kendall Keats, he's going to be sacked. Brandon Denmark, that's a good-looking defensive play.
Rattles brought the pressure. The safety took the dive, man, and left Denmark with the quarterback. And that's going to be a loss, going to bring up third down and 11. And again, the Rattlers go with their speed team with Curtis Alexander and Sean Ward at the tackle spots, ready to bring pressure.
Similar situation to the play Sean Ward scored on, Mike. Third down and 11. Lewis Kendall loads a spread formation with Cohen in the backfield. And Kendall trying to find an outlet. Rattlers giving chase. He completes this pass out here to Desmond Lawrence, and Lawrence is going to have the first down at the Rattler 30-yard line.
Kendall, able to slip out of the possible sack, is going to get it downfield. That's going to be a first down at the 30-yard line. 3:38 remaining now in the third quarter. Tie score, but the Aggies on the move.
A key conversion, too, Mike, for A&T on that play. And we've got whistles.
Yeah, we got a timeout.
Timeout called by FAMU with 3:28 to play. FAMU 7, A&T 7. We'll be back after these words from our local sponsors on the Rattler Sports Network. For North Carolina A&T, ball's resting at the Rattler 30 with 3 minutes and 28 seconds remaining in the third quarter. And we're all tied up at 7 apiece. Aggies going to send Desmond Lawrence wide to the far boundary this time, and Darryl Bullock is wide near side. They hand it off to Tariq Cohen, and he spins and turns, and Michael Dupree steps up to make the tackle.
That's Tariq Cohen.
Yeah, good move by Dupree, sort of coming under that block from his inside linebacker spot. He's going to hold him to only about a 2-yard gain. Frank tried to come back in, gave it a play right there, but he's going to have to go back out. And we've got a new nose guard in the game, and we'll give you that number in just a second.
Second down and seven for the Aggies. Kendall rolls right, looks back, tosses it for Cohen. And Michael Dupree once again on the play. Stops Cohen for a short gain. He's going to bring up third down now and about six to go for A&T.
Yeah, good discipline that time by the backside of the Rattler defense as he tried to throw like a little throwback screen. But the Rattlers were not fooled. They stayed disciplined and they make the tackle. Third down, about 7 yards to go, Keith. Another chance for the Rattler defense here to get off the field. And it's a tight, looks like a trick play. A trick play.
It is a trick play, and Tariq Cohen takes it in for the touchdown. That's a 27-yard run by Tariq Cohen, and the Aggies regain the lead.
Keith, there was a version of the old fumble rooski that the Nebraska Cornhuskers scored on, but this time it's a back. You could tell there was going to be something different by the way they lined up. Everybody went running to the right. One or two people stayed, and that was the person with the ball. He comes back to the left and puts the Aggies back on top.
Extra point attempt is on the way and good. Or no good. No good. It was a different kicker in, too. Jose Garcia Camacho came in to attempt the extra point, but it's no good. And so the Aggies take a 13-7 lead, and we'll be back after these words from our network sponsors on the Rattler Sports Network.
Subscription by going to Tallahassee.com. And as always, Rattlers will strike and strike and strike again.
Well, the Aggies score on a trick play. As Tariq Cohen goes in from 27 yards out, the extra point was no good. And the Aggies retake the lead 13-7. This is James Owens on the kickoff, and Owens is going to be dropped at about the 15-yard line where the Rattlers will begin first and 10 from there.
Yeah, he bobbled that ball and then had to bring it out. And now the Rattler offense has got to go back to work. The Aggies come down and answer the Rattlers' score with a touchdown of their own and go back up by six. 1:54 remaining in the third quarter.
I want to say hi to Elton Thomas tuning in today. I love talking to Elton. Elton always ends his conversations by saying, long live the spirit of the Million Man March. He's keeping track of both the FAMU and FSU games across the way. Two big games, Mike, in Tallahassee this afternoon.
Yep, lots of traffic over the weekend.
Yeah, here we go. Rattlers send Casey Glines in motion and toss the...
That's Linworth Lennon.
Linworth Lennon in. First time we've seen Linworth in about game and a half.
Yeah, actually two and a half maybe.
Yeah. And he's going to pick up about 3 yards on the play, maybe four. Let's call it... Yeah, second down and about seven to go.
Yeah, tried to go with the quick screen over to Linworth. No block right in front of him. He had to just get what he could. And Linworth, who set out the first half of this ball game, is now in and spit in.
Yeah, he's flanked wide to the near boundary. Casey glides to the far side, tied into the near side. That's the strong side of the formation for Damian Fleming. Orange helmets are down, and they give it to Omari Albert. And he's going to be stopped for no gain. He's going to make a third down and about seven to go for a Rattler first down.
Appalachian started off defeating, A&T started off defeating Appalachian State 24-21 up in Boone. They knocked off Elon by a score of 23-10. They beat Howard 27-19. At that side of their losing streak, South Carolina State came with a 29-24 win. That was up in the Georgia Classic in Atlanta. Howard knocked them off 31-26, and last week it was Delaware State 12, A&T 7.
Third down and seven for Damian Fleming. Fleming has one setback, and he sets up, looks the pass, dancing around, trying to find an open receiver. Tosses it downfield for Hall, and it's tipped in the air. Hall didn't make the catch, but then it was big number 88 for the Rattlers, Michael Etheridge, who also had a chance at it, but it falls incomplete and brings up fourth down for FAMU.
Yeah, and some mistake there because two Rattler receivers were pretty much in the same place.
I want to say hi to Laverne Stryker Washington and David Cush Campbell and all the brothers from the alley. Kick is fielded by Devontae Graham.
Oh, there's a block in the back right away. And it doesn't get a flag.
And Graham still on his feet at the 40, 35, 30, 25, and run out of bounds by Kobe Blanton. We got laundry on the field.
Yeah, that was the first man that came down was blocked in the back to get that return started, so that should come all the way back.
Now I want to say hi to Denard Basser, all the alley boys. And I want to say hi to Coach Claudette Farmer and alley girl.
The Bethune-Cookman Wildcats are in first place tied with the South Carolina State Bulldogs. They're 3-0 in the conference. Delaware State, Morgan State, and Hampton follow with only one loss.
I think Delaware is losing today, though.
Delaware State's losing today, so they'll pick up their second one. Both Morgan and Hampton winning today. So yeah, they'll be in third place tied.
Howard beat Morgan.
Okay, so we have only one team in third place. Team. Sort of thinning itself out as it goes along.
Yeah, it'll take care of itself, as they say. After the assessment, the Aggies going to start way back at their own 30-yard line now. After the block in the back, first and 10 for A&T.
Yeah, Delaware State really being handled by Hampton.
Yeah.
30-7.
16 seconds remaining in the third quarter. And Ken
is a reverse.
They're going to run the double reverse. They fumble the ball, and Patrick Aiken comes up and makes a sure tackle on Desmond Lawrence after maybe 2 yards gain.
And he had to make that play, Keith. There was nobody else on this side of the field. But give him credit, he stayed patient and fought off a couple of blockers to make that tackle. Actually holds it.
All right, second down for North Carolina A&T and about 8 yards to go as we begin the fourth and final quarter of this pivotal Mideastern Athletic Conference matchup. 13-7, the Aggies leading. And Kendall with receivers to either side. Rattlers bringing the blitz. They hand it off to Tariq Cohen, and Cohen looks like he's going to make it to the first down stick. We'll see where they spot the football. Might be spotted a little short.
Yes, a little bit short. It's going to be third down and less than a yard.
Yeah, Tariq Cohen is 5'8", 170-pound freshman out of Bund, North Carolina, and he has been the workhorse for North Carolina A&T.
Yeah, a lot of quickness and stronger than he looks.
Third down and one, they give it to Cohen, and Cohen across that 40-yard line, which will move the chains.
Hey, Keith and Mike, Frank the Tank is still over on the sidelines with a left shin injury. And right now I've been seeing who they are actually plugging in this spot. A number of players are still trying to find a fix. Number 97, James Broadus, and number 92, Michael Lovejoy. But also the sophomore out of Orlando, Romario Chisholm, number 91, 6'3", 260-pound sophomore.
All right, Lewis Kendall looking to pass. Throws back for the intended receiver, Tariq Cohen, but it's going to be incomplete. Second down and 10.
After three quarters of play, the North Carolina A&T Aggies have run 56 plays and picked up 219 yards of total offense. For the Rattlers of 4M, they've run 37 plays and only have 77 yards of total offense. Damian Fleming, 8 of 21 for 54 yards, leading rusher is still Al Tariq McBurst with 15 yards.
All right, here we go. Lewis Kendall on that read option keeps But good defense by the Rattlers to snuff that play out after about a two-yard gain. So bring up third down, maybe 3 yards. Third down and seven now for A&T.
And another chance for the Rattler defense to get off a third and long.
Looks like it was Brandon Denmark over there and Sean Howard snuffing that play out. Third down and long. Conversion, a possession play for A&T. Kendall looking to pass. He's in the grasp. He's sacked! James Broadus,
the big nose guard. Keith got a great bull rush right up the middle. When Kendall had to pull the football down, it was too late. The Rattlers were there, and it's going to bring a fourth down, and we're getting ready to get this ball back. Should get it with decent field position.
And I really like that play because Broadus fought off the guy who was trying to block him and made sure that Kendall could get away. Frescura on the punt. And here we go. This kick is going to be fielded by Terry Johnson. And Terry's going to be dropped right there at the 22-yard line.
Yeah, good job of fielding that punt and holding on by Terry Johnson. Taking a little chance there, but the Rattlers needing a spark. Lewis Kendall right now, Keith, 4 of 12 passing for only 18 yards. But Tariq Cohen has 150 yards in 21 carries. Yeah, he's been the workhorse.
He's been the workhorse. First and 10 Rattlers from our own 23-yard line. We're moving right to left now in the fourth quarter. We're headed toward the north end zone. And here we go. Rattlers decked out in the black uniforms today, orange helmets. Aggies in the road whites, blue helmets. Rattlers send the tight end in motion. And here we go. Hands it off to James Owens, and Owens scoots his way across the 30-yard line out to about the 33. And on first down, Mike, that's going to be a good 8-9 yard run for the speedster, James Owens. 9 yards on the carry.
Yeah, unfortunately on that play, looks like Dennis Hall got rolled up on his ankle, and he had to limp off the field there, and actually he's on the ground on the sideline.
Yeah, second down and one for the Rattlers. 12:06 to play. Rattlers trailing 13-7. Rattlers go twins to the near boundary, wing that side, and now send and run the jet sweep. And that's a good looking run, and we got a penalty marker thrown.
Yeah, that may be a face mask. But let's see. Flag came from the linesman on this side. Let's see if he's got holding or is that a face mask.
Well, there's a big discussion going on. That ball was run by number 86.
That's Montavious Williams.
Montavious, okay.
Boy, they're going to get us for a low block. And these are exactly the kind of penalties that'll drive killers.
Yeah.
Boy, that's huge. They got somebody for a low block. Going to bring up second down now and 12 with the ball just outside our own 20-yard line.
Keith and Mike, fam, you came into this game with 58 penalties for 447 yards.
Wow. Second down and 12 for the Rattlers, 11:31. Ball's back now at our own 21-yard line. Linworth Lennon goes in motion. He'll work the slot to the far side. Damian Fleming pulls it down. He's going to run. He's a block. Picks. Oh, got a great block. Oh, my goodness. Ooh.
Yeah, it was number 81 for the Rattlers, Dwayne Harvey.
And Dwayne tried to go. I think Dwayne might have hurt himself
with
that block.
Yeah, I think his shoulder got dinged a little bit on.
But that was an outstanding block.
Certainly freed his quarterback up for some more yardage, and we bring in Bice now to try to get this 1 yard to keep it moving.
So the Rattlers will pick up 11 yards on that play, make it third down and one. They were sprung by that tremendous block by Dwayne Harvey.
Yeah, gotta hurry here as the play clock all the way down to 5 seconds.
And we give it to Bice. Well, there was absolutely nowhere for Bice to run.
But we did not get the yard, and we actually, Keith, were lucky we didn't get a movement call. But he is not going to pick up the first down. As a matter of fact, he's going to lose a half yard.
Yeah, going to bring up fourth down and about one to go for the Rattlers.
Boy, and right now the Rattler offense is still on the field, but here comes the punt team.
Yeah, got a punt.
And let's go ahead and update you on the injuries. Dennis Hall, who limped off to the sidelines, just a right ankle injury. He told the training staff to let him breathe for a minute.
Fourth down, and Colby Blanton on the punt. The Rattlers going to be penalized for a delay of game. Now back us up five. .9:41 to play. The Rattlers trail by six. 13-7. Devontae Graham is deep to receive his punt. And Colby gets off a good punt. Graham calls for the fair catch and makes it at the 38-yard line. So the Aggies will begin first and 10 from there, from their own 38.
I got to look out for my road roomie. Robert Sr. They were messing with him pretty good up here at halftime about all his groceries. I think somebody they were trying to success. You don't get much home cooking.
That's how you know Jerome Swade is back in real form this week after the homecoming hangover. All right, here we go. Aggies hand it off to Tariq Cohen, and once again, Cohen, the workhorse, he spikes his way across the 40 out to about the 43-yard line. And on first down, that's going to be about a 4-yard gain, maybe a 5-yard gain. Let's call it second down at about, second down about six to go. Gain of four. Lewis Kendall under center this time, hands it off to Cohen once again. And he is tackled there by Jonathan Pillow. So bring up third down and about two to go for an Aggie first down.
Yeah, Pillow was on the blitz and the play was run inside him. He chases it down from behind. And there's gonna be another third down and one.
Possession play for A&T. Wouldn't be a FAMU home game without suspect checking in. Third down.
That's James Martin.
James Martin, 1.5. Aggies give it to
good defense.
Dominic Drake, and he is dropped for a loss on the play. It's going to make it fourth down for A&T.
Rattles about to get the football back as the clock winds down to 8 minutes in the ball game.
And I got to tell you, we struggled so much on offense today. Our only score came on a defensive play. Maybe Terry Johnson will have to take one to the house.
Yeah, well, he's going ahead and he's not fair catching it. He's giving it a go.
All right, here we go. Frescura to punt. Low kick. Terry's trying to tell the Rattlers, get away from it. And it's going to be down at the 25-yard line. So the Rattlers will take over. First and 10 from there. And we'll start at own 25 with 7 minutes and 31 seconds remaining in the ball game. I want to remind you, next week, the Rattlers journey to Norfolk, Virginia, to take on the Spartans of Norfolk State.
And they were in a third quarter 24-24 tie with Old Dominion.
Damian Fleming wants to pass. Boy, that pass is caught by Casey Glynn. That's a good-looking catch by the big receiver.
Going to gain about 8 yards on that first down play. Rattlers aren't going to get a lot more opportunities with only 7 minutes left. So we got to do something right here.
Yeah, gain of seven, about three to go. Casey Glides, the 6'6", 210 redshirt junior out of Neola, Utah. Second down and three, 6:59. Rattlers need to put a good drive together here, just like Mike said. Damian Fleming, empty backfield, five wides. And Fleming fires this pass just over the outstretched hands of Montavious Williams. Makes it third down and three for the Rattlers.
Keith and Mike, it should be noted that Quinn Gray has spent the second half back up in the booth with the headset on instead of being down on the sidelines calling all the action.
All right, third down and three for the Rattler offense. And Damian Fleming is going to send Montavious Williams and Casey Glines and Linworth Lennon triplets to the far boundary and isolate Dwayne Harvey over here to the near side. Blitz coming. And Damian's going to be sacked.
Well, the one thing as a quarterback you want to know, Keith, when you see the blitz come, you want to know where your answers are. No answers that time for Damian Fleming, who simply has to pull the ball down and take the sack. And with 6:24, we have to give the ball back to the Aggies.
It was Brian Houston, Mike, who made the tackle on the sack. Houston had 17 tackles a week ago for A&T. Kobe Blanton on the punt, gets off a end-over-end kick, and Graham feels it, gonna be dropped.
Well, Curtis Alexander was a great special teams play.
Yeah. All right, there's a break in the action. 6:01 to play, the Aggies leading it. We'll be back after this word from our network sponsors, the Rattler Sports Network.
Hey, Rattler fans, I'm Lecrae Mitchell, and the Rattler Boosters want you to know what's happening in FAMU athletics. Repeating as Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference champions is no guarantee, but the FAMU Lady Rattlers have it as their goal as they set their sights on the 2013 crown in Princess Anne, Maryland, on the campus of the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. FEA Kosuke leads the Lady Rattlers as she has all season, and she has made the MEAC Commissioner's all-academic team. Meanwhile, as the Florida A&M men's cross-country team begin final preparations to defend their MEAC cross-country title, the United States Track and Field and Cross-Country Coaches Association has moved the Rattlers up three spots to a number 9 ranking in the South region. Finally, next Saturday, the Rattler football team hits the road to Norfolk, Virginia to tangle with Norfolk State on the Spartans' homecoming. Kickoff is at 2 p.m. and Rattler Sports Network coverage begins at 1:30 p.m. Make sure you support the Rattlers. I'm Lecrae Mitchell, and go Rattlers!
14-yard gain on first down by Tariq Cohen gives the Aggies a first down at midfield. Should be noted, Mike, the men and women's cross-country team defended their MEAC titles today up in Maryland Eastern Shore.
Boy, and suddenly the Aggie ground game grinds out two quick first downs. And with the FAMU defense right now, needing to get that ball back to their offense.
Yeah, Tariq Cohen once again picks up 10 yards, and that's a first down for A&T. There's an injured Rattler down, and there's timeout on the field. 5:29 to play. Aggies up 13-7. We'll be back after these words from our local sponsors, the Rattlers Sports Network.
The North Carolina A&T Aggies hold a 13-7 lead over the FAMU Rattlers. It's 5:29 remaining here in the fourth quarter. The Aggies have a first down at the Rattler 38-yard line. And here we go, one back behind Lewis Kendall. Rattlers bring pressure. That ball is to Cohen. He cuts back. And this time, Cohen is going to be stopped by James Broadus for just a one-yard gain. And he's going to bring up second down and 10. As the clock continues to run. Under 5 minutes now, the Rattlers desperately need to get the football back. As you can see now that A&T trying to run as much of the play clock as they can. They're not even gonna get the call until about 10 seconds to go. as they work the Rattlers and they work the clock at the same time. Cut back one this time by Cohen as he tries to stretch it to the left. That wasn't Jerome. Just want everybody to know.
Oh my God.
It's gonna be held for no gain.
Yeah, Jerome had to take a break.
It's gonna be third down and 10, folks. Another chance for the Rattlers to get off the field defensively. And this is the biggest one of the ball game. It's third down, a little more than 10 yards with the clock down to 4 minutes to go.
A possession play for North Carolina A&T. Lewis Kendall from the gun. And they give it to Dominic Drake. And Drake is going to pick up about three, maybe four. But it's going to bring a fourth down for the Aggies. Now decision time for Ron Broadway here.
Yeah, the Rattlers choose not to use their timeout. And Coach Broadway, Keith, is going to let this clock run all the way down. More than likely take the five-yard penalty, then go ahead and punt.
The punt unit is checking on for A&T. It'll be Dominic Frescura on the punt. And the Rattlers are going to send Trayvon Holmes deep to receive.
And now the Aggies are going to call a timeout.
All right. Big fourth down play here. Dominic Frescura on the punt. And boy, he shanks it, but it takes an Aggie roll. And the Rattlers pick the ball up at the 1 yard line and almost tackled in the end zone. So we're going to start first and 10 at our own three. Mikey should have let that one just roll into the end zone.
Yeah, it wasn't the return man, Terry Johnson. It was somebody who had come down to try to throw Terry a block. I think what he was afraid of, Keith, was the ball hitting him and then being recovered by the Aggies, so he just grabbed it. Unfortunately for the Rattlers, he goes down. Well, he was first touched at the 4 yard line, so that's where the Rattlers were scrimmaged from.
2 minutes and 58 seconds, and the Rattlers have to negotiate some 96 yards of real estate because we need a touchdown, Mike, to tie, and then the extra point to win.
Yeah, but we have not scored an offensive touchdown all day.
Right. Casey Glines checks in. He'll work the slot near side. Rattlers in a spread formation. Linworth Lennon is working the slot on the far side. Damian in the end zone. He's going to throw downfield. Got a couple of receivers down there, and boy, it's nearly picked off. One Rattler, at Mason Felix, had to play defense to keep that pass from being picked off.
Yeah, they ran four verticals. They had a one-on-one. That ball seemed to hang up in the air a little bit. And you're right, Keith, a good job of playing defense by the family receiver to prevent an interception. It's going to bring up second down and 10. 2:51 now remaining.
Yeah, second down and 10 for the Rattlers from our own 4 yard line. 2:51 to play.
Yeah, and only 7 seconds left on the play clock, and the Rattlers got a hurry.
Damian still in the end zone, has a back back there with him this time for blocking. He's going to pull it down. He's got some running room, and he takes off it. He's going to be out of bounds at about the 12 yard line. He's going to bring up third down. Third down, about two to go. That's a good-looking run for Damian.
Yeah, and he got out of bounds to stop the clock. Yeah, 2:43 remaining.
All right, ball spotted. Third down and two. Clock is ticking at 2:30.
I think it only stops when you go out of bounds under two.
Okay. Here we go. Casey Glines wide to the near boundary. And Twins to the far side. We got spread formation. Twins to either side. And Damian, boy, going to be forced out of that pocket. Fires this pass and overthrows the intended receiver.
And let's see if the Rattlers got to go right here, I think.
Yeah, third down and two. With 2:05 to play, we need to get a first down.
Yeah, it's a big chance, but right now we've got to go. And this is the ball game right here, folks. Fourth down and two. Yeah. Rattlers at their own 13-yard line. If we don't get these 2 yards, we would turn it over to the Aggies already would be in field goal range. So this is it right here. Rattlers got to get a first.
Rattlers need a first down. We go back to the spread formation. Looks like Lamon Bice is the Rattler running back on 4th and 2. And Damian's going to set up the screen pass. And
right, gets the first down. Good.
Is that Linworth?
Looks like may have been Linworth, Keith, whoever it was, did a good job.
Linworth Lennon stretches his body and puts that football. Linworth's not a tall guy, but he stretched that ball out.
As far as he could.
As far as he could.
Picks up the first down. 1:52 to go.
Ball's resting now at our own 17-yard line. Damian has time. Going to fire this pass across the middle. That pass is caught by Linworth Lennon. And what a difference Linworth Lennon makes in this offense.
There's no question, Keith. He's our number one playmaker. 1:41, while they move the chains. Rattlers now at their own 39-yard line and with the drive going.
Spread formation, receive twins to either side for Damian Fleming. And Fleming lost this one out there. And boy, Linworth can't hold on to that one.
Went after it with one hand. Went after with one hand, and it gets away from him and goes out of bounds. 1:27 to go now. Second down and 10 from our own 39. Rattlers with one last chance to try to pull this one out.
Minute 27 to play in the ball game. Rattlers trail by 6. And the ball is resting at our own 39-yard line. We need a touchdown and the extra point. Got to get 7. Spread formation for Damian Fleming. And Fleming sets up, wants to pass, pulls it down. He's got running room. He's got the first down. Fleming in Aggie territory, down at the 41-yard line of A&T.
Minute 19 remaining. Rattlers with a first down at the Aggie 42. Clock momentarily stops while they move the chains. Still got the spread formation going. Damian Fleming calling the play at the line of scrimmage.
One setback. Twins to either side. Fleming again looking to pass. Shovels it to Owens.
And the Rattlers immediately call timeout. He was short of the sticks and didn't get out of bounds. So with 58 seconds to go, the Rattlers call time.
Yard line. Rattlers need 7. Rattlers are threatening. Damian Fleming spread formation. One setback. And that setback is James Owens. Rattlers in all black. Orange helmets are down. He throws the quick out. It's caught. And quickly out of bounds. Very smart play. The Rattlers get the first down, move the chains, and stop the clock.
53 seconds now remaining. The Rattlers down to the Aggie 30-yard line.
Dennis Hall was the receiver. Very smart play. Rattlers only ran about, 3 seconds off the clock.
Yeah, and now under 2 minutes when you go out of bounds, the clock remains stopped until the next snap.
All right, ball's at the Aggie 30 for 53 seconds. Rattlers send triplets to the near boundary, isolate a receiver to the far side. It's Owens in the backfield with Damian. And Damian going to be flushed out of the pocket, fires this pass downfield. He just threw this one away to buy time, and it stops the clock.
Yeah.
46 seconds.
Yeah, the Aggies brought the blitz from the wide side of the field, forcing Damian to roll into the short side. He just had to throw that one away. 46 seconds now.
Second down and 10. And ball resting at the 30-yard line for 46 seconds.
Yeah, they get big Casey Glines back into the game, but it doesn't look like Linworth Lennon is on the field, and that is the guy that we need out there. Only 12 seconds remaining on the play clock. Got to hurry right here. Don't need a penalty.
Yeah, triplets to the far boundary. And Mason Felix is the isolated receiver to the near side. And Damian steps up in the pocket.
Got running room
downfield. He's got a run, and he gets out of bounds. He's not going to get the first down, but he's only going to be about 2 yards short with 39 seconds remaining.
Yeah, it looks like at about the 22-yard line, 39 seconds to go. Best drive that the Rattlers have had all day. We do it right now at the end, but I think, Keith, what you see is Damian Fleming doing what Damian Fleming does best with a spread formation and tossing that football around.
Third down, about 3 yards to go. And the Rattlers send. It's like James Owens even over there in one of the slots.
Yeah, got Linworth on the other side of the slot.
Yeah, five wides, and boy, he throws this one out there. Got a penalty marker thrown on the play. Damian was hit as he released the football. Let's see what this was going to be. Pass interference.
It's interference against the Aggies. It's going to be interference against the Aggies. That'll give the Rattlers a first down. That's going to be a half the distance from the goal penalty. The ball is going to be spotted. It looks like he's inside the 10-yard line.
Yeah, 35 seconds remaining in the ball game. Ball's going to be marked at the 8-yard line of A&T.
And the Rattlers, Keith, actually have a timeout in the bag to use. Just can't take any losses right here.
Linworth Lennon is in the huddle. Casey Glines goes wide to the far boundary. It's Dwayne Harvey, Linworth Lennon, and Ad Mason Felix, the triplets to the near side. And it's James Owens. This pass is caught. And boy, did he get out of bounds? No, he did. Clock's still rolling.
Yeah, gotta call the timeout right here. We got one in the bag. Gotta call that timeout, and we do.
And the Rattlers take time. 13-7, Aggies lead, 24 seconds remain, and we'll be back after these words from our network sponsors on the Rattlers Sports Network.
You've been involved in an accident? You feel like today is gonna be a bad day? You have headaches, neck pain, back pain? Well, call us here at Tallahassee Accident and Rehab, where we have your neck and your back. Call me, Dr. Ways, at Tallahassee Accident and Rehab. We're located at 1711 South Gaston.
Second down and goal to go for the Rattlers of Florida A&M. Ball's resting at the Aggie 8. Aggies lead 13-7. There are 24 seconds remaining in this ball game. If the Rattlers are going to do it, they've got to do it right here.
And the Rattlers really showing a little short stack formation that we haven't seen a lot of. Two-by-two formation.
Owens in the backfield. Damian looks to pass, going to throw the over the shoulder. Did he catch it?
He caught it.
Touchdown, Fairview. Who caught it?
That looks like that's number 81, Dwayne Harvey.
Dwayne Harvey. He made up for the one he dropped last week, Mike.
Dwayne Harvey was being interfered with. Still comes down with the catch. There's 19 seconds remaining, and the score is tied. And we have a chance now, Keith, to take the lead with only 19 seconds to go in the ball game.
Chase Bonador on for the go-ahead. The Rattlers' first go-ahead of the afternoon. Let's see if Chase can put it through. Here's the snap placement. Kick is airborne. And
it's no good. It's no good, Keith. There was a bad snap. It was a bad snap. The Rattlers had a hard time getting it down. And the score is tied.
We're all tied up at 13. Boy, that was a big miss.
Carson Wall did his best, Keith. The snap sort of skirted along the ground. He did his best to try to get it down, but the kick is called no good, and we made.
The Aggies have two deep men to receive this kick. Received at the 5, 10, 15, 20. And finally down at the 25-yard line goes number 25.
Actually, it's closer to the 35.
The 35, yeah. Tony McRae And so A&T will get the football, first and 10 from their own 35-yard line with 10 seconds remaining in the ball game.
Well, how do you miss that extra point? As Coach Holmes can say, we have a hard time sometimes getting out of our own way.
Yep. First and 10 for the Aggies, and they're going to go into the victory formation to send this game into overtime. 13-13 is our score, and that's going to be the end of regulation. So this game is going into overtime, and we're all tied up. So while we have a break in the action, we'll be back to Bragg Stadium as we go to overtime. FAMU and North Carolina A&T tied at 13 after these words from our network sponsors on the Rattler Sports Network. And who will this, what day, let's see if we can pick this up, some sound.
Rattlers wants to talk. The Rattlers won the toss. They will go on defense first.
Yeah, so that, if whatever the Aggies do, then we'll know what we need to do to tie the game
or go ahead and win the game.
All right. So we head to overtime. FAMU and A&T. First time this season, Mike, we've been in overtime. So a new experience. This may be Coach Earl Holmes' first overtime as a head coach.
Exactly, it is. No question about it. And it's a situation that has to be managed. It's something that you have to grow into also, these overtime situations. But definitely, you want to be on defense first. Because if you turn it over, if they turn it over, then you know all you need is to get it in the middle and knock through the field goal.
Keith and Mike, I've been down here on the FAMU sidelines after that missed point after by Chase Barnador. He is taking it pretty hard, but the special teams coordinator, Juan Vasquez, went over and said, we still need you, we still need you, trying to get his spirits back up. Coach Holmes told him to come over to him, said, talk to me. And Coach Holmes, they were really just trying to embrace him and let him know they still need him if they're going to win this game.
All right, the Aggies are going to start on offense. First and 10, Kendall is going to load up an offset eye and give to Cohen on first down. And that's great defense there by number 47, Mike, Akil Blunt, and number eight.
Denmark.
Yeah,
Denmark definitely getting through.
I want to thank our engineer, Jerome Swain, for helping us out on that one. Here we go. Lewis Kendall, offset eye, gives to Cohen, tries to turn the corner, and he's ridden out of bounds by Michael Ducree.
Boy, it's going to be, and then we get a penalty marker out of bounds. It's going to be a late hit out of bounds against the Rattlers, so that is going to be a half the distance marker.
What is it up? Let's see what they're calling. Those are those penalties, Mike, that just really. Michael Ducree is going to be called for the late hit out of bounds.
Yeah, and Ducree's had an outstanding game. 8 tackles on the day, 5 solos. Only Brandon Denmark has had a better day.
All right, Kendall and the Aggies now inside the 10. Boy, they run a reverse flip in for the touchdown. Goes Tariq Cohen. And so the Aggies get 6, and they'll get a chance for the extra point. The Rattlers will have to score a touchdown to send it into double overtime.
Right, which makes it 4 down territory now for the Rattlers. They know they have to score a touchdown to tie this ball game back up.
Cody Jones on to attempt the point after for A&T. Here we go. Snap and placement. Kick is on the way. And it's good. So in overtime, the Aggies score a touchdown. So A&T scores first, and we'll be back after these words from our network sponsors on the Rattler Sports Network.
When security is essential, Palmetto Security Services offers superior knowledge in the security business. Palmetto Security has expanded this expertise into the screening industry. Palmetto Security provides fully trained and screened officers to maintain a secure environment. Our physical security services are designed to provide the maximum protection at events, a business, or in an educational environment. For more information, call 850-329-6596 or on the web at www.pssoffl.com.
Hey, Rattlers! For the most complete coverage of all home and away Florida A&M football games, you can count on the Tallahassee Democrat and Tallahassee.com. From kickoff to the marching 100 to the final touchdown, the Tallahassee Democrat has all you need to be the best FAMU fan in town. Make sure you grab a Sunday Tallahassee Democrat or purchase your very own subscription by going to Tallahassee.com. And as always, Rattlers will strike and strike and strike again.
Damian Fleming sets up, wants to pass. He's going to be sacked way back at the 36-yard line. So Damian's going to lose about 11 yards on that play. Rattlers have to score a touchdown. We're moving in the wrong direction.
Yeah, that's not a good way to get this drive started. But again, it's four down territory. And the Rattlers have to get to the 15-yard line for a first down.
Rattlers now send triplets to the far boundary. Twins over here near side. Five wides, no backs for Damian Fleming. And Fleming sets up. Shakes away from an Aggie, fires this pass to Casey Glines. He makes the catch at the 22-yard line.
That makes it a much more manageable third down.
Yeah, third down.
It's like about seven to go.
Third and about seven.
Good job by Damian of stepping up in the pocket and
finding an open receiver.
And finding Glines, yeah.
Yeah, looked like he was going to take off and run, but then he saw Casey and shot that pass out to him. Third down and seven for the Rattlers.
Yeah, we got two downs. To pick up these 7 yards.
Yeah. Right now, we just need a first down. Here we go. One setback. Glines is wide near side. Tight end to the near side as well. And here we go. Damian steps up. Fire step.
Oh, that's pass interference.
Oh! He was hit before the ball got there.
Boy, we don't get the interference call. It was definitely pass interference as the defender came over the back of the intended receiver to knock that ball away.
How could the umpire miss that call?
Actually, the back judge should have made that call. It's fourth down.
Wow, the umpire. But it happened right in front of the umpire. Fourth down for the Rattlers and seven.
Again.
Your ball game is right here.
Ball game right here.
Rattlers go. Triplets to the far boundary. Glines isolated near side. Omari Albert is in the backfield. And Damian fires this pass. It's picked off. And that's going to be the ball game. The Aggies. Isaiah Martin picks off the pass and preserves the win for North Carolina A&T, and our Tallahassee Democrat Rattler wrap-up show begins after these words from our local sponsors on the Rattler Sports Network.